humiliated ourselves. Yes, yes. Let's get back to your stunning career. No, seriously, Bebe and Carmen, were you the kids who showed up at the talent show and everybody was like, well, there's no point?
Mm-hmm. No, we were nervous. Well,
yeah.
Because there was such great singers in Detroit, Michigan.
And at our high school. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So when we did the talent shows, you had to really come with
and
it.
And we were singing gospel, so it was like, uh-oh, yeah, we really got to come straight. Mm-hmm. But that's what my father taught us. My father used to say to me, look, you're not going to be the greatest singers in the world, but you're going to be the most confident singers in the world. And sometimes people may mistaken that for conceited, but you're not conceited, you're just confident. So we would get up and just, hey, let's just go for it.
Well, plus, when you're singing gospel, you can't get booed, right? So that's...
Oh, you can?
Oh, yeah.
You
can? I thought that was
especially
a rule.
At our school.
Oh, no. They'll boo you in Jesus' name.
Well, Carmen, you never got booed when you worked for some of the legends of the industry. You worked with everyone from Michael Jackson, Whitney Houston, Stevie Wonder, and Quincy Jones.
Yes.
She's still laughing.
I know.
So funny. Sorry, you can't stop being funny. Talk to us about these working with these iconic figures and what impact these collaborations had.
You know, it's funny because when we'd be talking, we were little and we had our own Grammy Awards, right? We would dream about singing with some of these people, right? And as we got older and got into the business, of course, singing with Stevie, being on Quincy's label, singing with Michael Jackson, it was just amazing.
Than your family, who have you enjoyed collaborating with the most?
Well, you know what? The fact that we met Whitney because she opened for Jeffrey Osborne she was singing in her set tomorrow.
Right.
You know, what you just tried to
sing.
But she really sounded real well.
Okay.
You know, Let's
just focus on tomorrow. We can't look back at that.
Okay, but you meet these people and you find out how your music has gone before you and touched their lives. And so you realize the power in music, you know? And so you meet these people and, I mean, my favorite was Gladys Knight. And I remember me and my brother, Ronald, we were in the JCPenney's and we were hiding behind the clothes and we saw, oh my God, Gladys Knight. And then she saw us and said, y'all come from under them clothes and come over here and meet me. And so it was just like to meet her, to work with her, to write for her, to produce her. It's beyond your dreams, you know, but that's what music can do.
You actually spoke at Whitney's funeral. What do you think her legacy has been since her passing?
You know, that's so hard. You know, for us, we miss her so much because she became family. Mm-hmm. She was more than just a great singer and just a friend you saw every now and then, but she was the godmother to my children and Cece's the godmother to her daughter. And so she was family. So to lose a family member like that, I think we're still... We're still going to see down the line what she really meant to the world through her music, you know. But the lesson that I've learned is, you know, you really have to take care of yourself. You really do. Beyond the glitter, beyond the applause, you really have to love yourself and take care of yourself because it's difficult.
And that God-given instrument.
Oh, my
God. You have to take care of that.
Yes. And now you're sharing with the world the story of the Whitney that you knew in this book that you wrote. Tell us more about the book.
You know, this was therapeutic for me. You know, you hear a lot of things what people thought and, you know, she was this or she did that. And to know the truth, you know, sometimes you try to be silent, but it was just one, you know, phone call to me to say, you know what, you knew her. Talk about what you knew. And so I just share a lot of things that people don't know, the giving part of Whitney, you know. For me personally, the house that I first moved in, my first home, you know, the people changed the amount that I had to give because they would say, you know, musicians was a risk. And, you know, we would talk about everything. And she showed up at my my apartment and said, let's go buy that house that they won't give you. And turned around and gave an envelope and said, go get it.
Whitney bought your house?
She didn't buy. She gave me the amount that was needed. It was $50,000 to get my house, which was so surprising. At the same time, it was who she was. But when I turned around, just like any other family member, and paid her back, she was still shocked.
Really?
You know, because she didn't expect that to come back. Because people don't do that, you know? They just take from you and keep taking from you and keep taking from you. But that was the Whitney we knew.
Wow. I can't wait to read this book.
I know.
Thank you.
Intimate stories.
Intimate.
So what's next for you two?
Well, This album, and we're going to
tour land. Yeah,
you want to tell them the kind of tour we're going to do?
Well, the tour that they're saying we're going to do is if you hear 3WB coming to town, come, because we won't be back.
Are you kidding? No.
Oh, yes. You know,
I
that
mean,
kind of
touring, you know,
that's for...
We will be
how long will you be on tour?
People his
some
age.
Of the stops? 20. 20.
Yeah. Hey, hold on to it. You're doing good. You're doing good. You know, but it's the wear and tear of touring. Mm-hmm. No.
It's tough.
It is tough. Yeah.
You lose days, you lose months, you lose a lot of things. And so it's not even a desire. But because we really do believe in the album and we love live, we love singing live, we will go. But if you hear we're in your city, please come. Because we're not coming back.
Well, where can we get your tour list at? What's the website?
We can go to 3winansbrother.com.
Okay.
And you can pick up everything that's there.
Oh, in the meantime, can you sing us to break?
Yes.
Without Shannon?
I got you back up. I'll be on tour with them. Don't worry.
Please don't go. That's the song you wrote.
I know, but you catch me off guard. Just do the...
I need you so. Keep your loving arms around me, don't let go. Say it again, say, don't go. Nobody else will love me if you go. You there, you with us? Yeah. You got it?
I'm good.
I'm
waiting for you to come in on the 3-5 harmony.
Keep your loving arms around me, don't let go. Hold on, let that.